So I've had a blast watching everybody's videos on this whole New Mutants thing. I've actually watched everyone that I could find because it's hilarious to watch everybody's reactions on this. Everybody is reacting. And what's really funny about this is it's not the typical people that you would expect, like myself, to comment on this. I see people that are on the other side of the aisle that are not digging this. And that's what we're going to get into, because I'm shocked. You would think that the people that they're trying to cater to with this comic book would be all about, yes, it's going to be a huge hit. Marvel's finally going to make the best comics ever. No, they're not liking this. And I think that that's probably the most surprising thing out of everything here. So let's go over a couple of things real quick. Now, one thing I wanted to give a little update on is the trailer over on Marvel Entertainment. New Warriors trailer, Marvel Comics. Now, this is where it all came from. And look at the downvote ratio. Look at the ratio. Beautiful. How glorious it is when everyone can come together and just not like something as a whole. I love it. I love it. And it's showing. That's pretty spectacular. Marvel Entertainment's a funny channel because they don't even get a tenth of their viewers to watch their content. As long as you're getting a tenth of your subscription base to watch your content, I think you're doing pretty good. This channel can't get very many people to watch it. They put a lot of really cringy content on here. You could do a whole video or even a live stream going over their content and how bad it is. They like do these weird food shows and everything. But nonetheless, this is being destroyed and everybody in the comments seems to hate it. They are way too intimidating. Imagine being imitated by what is essentially stylized scribbles. It's honestly depressing that this is what Marvel has become, and they still don't understand why their comic sales are plummeting. Well, back to reading Berserk, like most people. Because, well, let's tell the truth here. Marvel comics and comics in general don't sell. Manga is really what the big thing is now. That's what everyone cares about. And this is why. This is why people like manga, because you don't have trash like this. And really good point that I should have brought up in my video where I talked about this the other day. Why does that one character, like, so his name is like Screen Time, this guy right here. What is internet gas? So apparently Screen Time got his powers from internet gas. What the hell is internet gas? I'm really confused here, but Marvel in general confuses me because they're a trash company now. They literally have, I'll give them this. They have five really good comic books. Five really, really good comic books like Venom. Venom is a really good comic. But for every one Venom, they've got 14 or 15 New Mutant books, which is the problem. Watch my other video that I did. It's got a picture of Snowflake and Snowflake and Space Safe Space on it. I talk about a lot more than just the New Mutants in that video. So make sure you check that video out because I do think it's a good video. So what's going on here? So we got to know the Mary Sue where they let their frustrations loose. They actually did a little bit of research on this topic and found that people aren't happy with these characters. The people that these characters are supposed to make happy don't like them. So for once, it seems everybody agrees that something is trash. Not surprisingly, though, they're upset because of who created them. This man right here, who I froze in the video on the page. They don't like that he created these characters. I think, what does it matter who creates the characters or writes the story as long as it's good? I don't think that should matter. This should please a lot of these people, but they don't like it. And it's a shame. Like, if somebody writes a good story, it should be supported, in my opinion. And, you know, it is what it is. These people are never happy. And it shows why you should never try to market towards them. Just make the characters you want to make and put it out there. Capitalism will sort it out. But, you know, they don't want to do that. They want to put this stuff out there. And Marvel, of course, does this at the expense of comic shop owners. So here's the two biggest things right here. Just like I said, we have a tweet by Kate Leth, who's working on High Guardian Spice right now, former comic book writer. I don't know if she's still writing comics, probably not, because all of them were garbage. And notably, she got kicked out. So she says, personally, I love to see two white cis men at Marvel create a black non-binary character named Snowflake in the year of our Lord 2020. Of course, like I said, complaining about the guy who created the characters. And that's kind of the big thing right here. So this guy, this Daniel Kittlesmith guy, is an ally. Created the book Santa's Husband. Should tell you this guy, you know, loves the communities he's trying to promote here. Unfortunately, they're not getting his back. They're attacking him because of who he is. And he's generally trying to please them and give them what they want, which I find absolutely hilarious. It's just show. It's the old, what's the old saying, you know, NPCs always eat their own. That's what's going on right here. Look at this one. So we have the Snowflake and Safe Space characters right here complaining about that. By the way, Safe Space is supposed to be a jock. And I didn't mention this in my video, but I watched it in Gun, and it's a Gundam's video. And he said, how many jocks look like this guy? He said, like, I've been beat up a bunch of times and none of them look like this. I thought that was pretty funny. But he's a funny dude, so not to pile on and not to speak for the NB community, which I believe is non-binary, but gender norms like blue and pink, for example, even if you are wink, wink, flipping them, that's basically talking about how Safe Space is wearing pink and Snowflake is wearing blue. Snowflake identifies as a female, and then Safe Space is, of course, non-binary. And apparently, according to this Twitter user here, are exactly the thing that non-binary folks want nothing to do with. This feels like it was created without any input or research, which is exactly the thing that even the writer of this article talks about. They're upset that not enough research was done. Like, you can, and this is the thing. This is why they say you'll never be woke enough. You'll never be woke enough. This is why this is just a bad venture to go into, because it's never going to be good enough. It's never woke enough. They'll never be happy. All these people do is get mad about stuff. And when it tries to cater to them, they just find more reasons to get pissed about it. So anyway, let's get into some of the argument here. Luciano Vecchio is a Q man. And as I said before, Kibblesmith has a history of being an ally, but that doesn't automatically mean you have a full range of language to create every kind of character. If people within the community are saying that this feels off and insulting in good faith, then I think that should be listened to. I'm not an NB. See, that's a new term. I've never heard the word NB, but apparently that means non-binary. But just by naming a black non-binary character Snowflake and partying them up with a black male character Safe Space, named Safe Space, sounds weird. I am 100% agree with you on this. I'm glad we agree on this. And the names are stupid. I don't know. See, this is the problem with Marvel Comics, and I talked about this in my last video. Who's approving this trash? You know, this is just a stupid book, and it's gonna fail. Mark my words, it's going to fail. It'll be a bombed book by issue at least 20. And they're going to give it 25 issues. I promise you. They've let books fall to like 6,000 shipped issue. I think that was Iceman. I'm not sure. But they will let books fail and fail spectacularly. So we'll see what happens here. There should have been more people taking a look at this within the community. You can't please everyone, and not every criticism is valid, but I have yet to see a lot of responses from within the NB community that are in praise of these choices. And that's what I saw that was really funny to talk about. So apparently the writer of this article looked around and no one's liking this. So nobody from either side of the aisle likes this book. Everybody thinks it's stupid. And the fact that everybody thinks it's stupid, it means that this is going to fail even more spectacularly. Representation matters, and it needs to be a lot more. Then there needs to be a lot more thought put into it than this. Even the idea of reclaiming these terms is something that feels very 3 years ago. Plus, reclaiming has come from within the community, not from the minds of two cis white males. So it needs to come from within their community, but not from those white guys. So anyway. She goes on to say that she's down with the idea to be inclusive, but this is stupid. And I'm 100% agreeing with you. This is dumb. It's going to fail. But I do find it funny that everyone hates it. It's so rare that everybody is on board with the same thing. And it's kind of nice. So we are all united in thinking that this is stupid. Does anybody out there like this? Is there anybody praising this? I'll have to check shill media. Now, it'll be funny because, you know, CBR is going to make positive articles on this. Bleeding Cool is going to make positive articles on this. So we're going to have some, there'll be some fun content from this. And you know, one thing that's nice is having fun right now because everything that's going on. So we will revisit this, I'm sure, in the future. And I will 100% buy this when it comes out. And we will take a look at it. Anyway, guys, I'd like to thank Optimus Deadpool over on Twitter for making this lovely correction to the characters of this book. But leave me your thoughts. What do you think about all this? Are you surprised that they are not loving this book? I thought they would be praising it. I was kind of shocked that it seems that everyone is against it, which is pretty funny. Anyway, give me your thoughts on that. Throw a like up if you would. Share the video. I would really appreciate that because I can't really share anything on Twitter. I don't know how long shadow bans last. So please share the video. Interact with it. Make sure you still subscribe. Subscribe if you're new. Hit that notification bell, and I'll see you guys on the next one. Peace. Also, if you want to help support the channel, check out my Teespring store. There's a link in the description. You can find some merchandise in there that you might want to check out. Also, take a moment. Make sure you're still subscribed to the channel. There's something going on right now, and they've been unsubscribing people. So just take a second and double check on that, and subscribe if you're new.